Welcome to Southern Maryland Sports Journal. I'm your host, Travis Thomas. You know, here at the end of the year, as a new one is about to begin, a lot of us are in the mood for reflection. So do me a favor and think back to what you were doing February of last year. It's been a long time, right? Well, that's how long it's been since St. Mary's men's college basketball has lost at home. But you know what they say about all good things, right? Seahawks came in riding a four-game win streak and that aforementioned impressive home win record. They believe that they will win at home against DeSales. It looked good early, that's for sure, thanks to junior captain Nick. Don't call me the Prince Laguerre. This kid's game is silky, and he had it working from both inside and outside. A little bit of this, a little bit of that, a little bada bing, a little bada boom. Laguerre, a game high, 24 points. But St. Mary's would trail 36-35 at the half. Unfortunately, more of the same in the second half. DeSales led by as many as 18 points in this one. Despite that fact, however, Seahawks forward Troy Spurrier, no relation to the old ball coach Steve, to my knowledge, turns in the highlight of the night with a two-fisted finish in a losing effort nonetheless as St. Mary's falls 80-70 at home.
I mean, it's tough because, you know, we have a record, a reputation of not losing home, so it's tough getting the loss. But, I mean, as long as we learn something from it, it's not too bad. The bottom of the line, they just played harder than us. They just wanted it more than us, and their bench was real active, so they just got out with the win.
It's disappointing in so much that we really, really value our fans. We really value the community that comes out to the games, and we really value the students that come out here and support the team. So it's disappointing in that we do feel like we let them down in our performance tonight. But at the same time, I mean, we love them because that, you know, we know they'll be back, and we know they understand that, you know, you can't win. You try to win the national championship every year, but it's a, you know, I know the standards have really risen here over the years. But you know, our team is a work in progress right now. We know that. I think the fans know that. You know, we'll look at the positives out of this game, which I think, again, we played the last 4 minutes really hard. And we'll look at the negative, you know, as far as our defense and rebounding. And we'll try to get better.
The last time we had Great Mills High School hoops on this show, they were beating down rival Leonardtown. But we've yet to see another Hornets rival so far this season. Let's head to Choptacon, home of the Braves, for their season home opener against the Hornets. Choptacon faithful were charged up early for the home opener against Great Mills, and the boys got off on a good foot. Braves win the opening tip, and right away, senior guard Darren Smith buries the J. 2-0 Braves at that point. That would be short-lived, however. Everybody and they mamas would answer back on the Hornets. Here's proof. Peep the video montage of gratuitous Great Mills buckets that I put together through the magic of editing, of course. During this Hornets run, I had a Mountain Dew, a little popcorn, a hot dog, some ketchup, relish, mustard, in case you were wondering. Quite naturally, Great Mills was up big at the half, 45-18. Choptacon would not go quietly into the night, however. The second half was a new game, it seemed like. Nick Gagnon spots up and makes it rain threes. The Braves would chip away at the lead, gathering the loose ball, and Nick Hughes finishes strong at the cup. Braves feeling it. Pierre Mitchell hits the three ball, all up in it. It's a 13-point deficit now. Are you kidding me? But in the end, there was just too much Great Mills. CJ Sampson finds TJ McLeod inside for 3 points the old-fashioned way to seal the deal. 76-51, Great Mills.
Every time we play Leonardtown and Choptacon, we tell them the practices before that you throw out the records. Forget whatever the records are. Everybody's going to step up their game. You're going to get the intensity from the players. You're going to get the intensity from the crowd. And you can't get caught up in that. If you do, then you can, whether you think you're expected to win or not, you can go in and lose a game in which you really expected to win.
Thank you for watching Southern Maryland Sports Journal with me, Travis Thomas, exclusively on MetroCast Channel 10.
Changing times brings changing needs. That's why for your convenience, Booth's Heating and Air have extended their service hours to 10 hours a day, Monday through Saturday at regular service rates. Through rigorous training classes and courteous business practices, Booth's technicians always go above and beyond to provide you with award-winning customer service that you can trust. Booth's Heating and Air, serving the Southern Maryland area since 1993.